Biocoordination chemistry. We already discussed this starting brief introduction regarding biocoordination chemistry and how it's chemistry in everyday life and what are the metals present in our human body, what are the interdisciplinary. We are already discussed this. So now we are going to discuss some of the oxygen transport as well as storage of proteins, enzymes like that. So oxygen transport and storage. The protein structure, basically the protein structure and building blocks of the amino acids. This is the basic structure of amino acid. There is a carboxylic acid group, that is the COOH on one side. There is an amino acid group, that is NH2 on the other side. Amino acid have side chain which are unique to each individual amino acids. So primary structure, a linear sequence of the amino acid in a polypeptide chain. They are held together by covalent bonds like a peptide bonds. Each polypeptide chain has an N terminus and a C terminus. This depends on the amino acid at the end of the polypeptide chain on either side, with the function group not involved in peptide bond. The secondary structure, let us see secondary structure. We have hydrogen bonds forming the between the main chain peptide groups. Example for the resulting structure are alpha helix and beta helix, beta sheet. The hydrogen bonds are formed between the amide hydrogen and the carbonyl oxygen contains in the backbone peptide bonds of the protein. And the tertiary structure, let us see tertiary structure shown on the slide left side. There are the special arrangements of the secondary structure proteins. The alpha helical or beta sheets of the are further folded to form a tertiary structure. These proteins are also known as a globular protein. Tertiary structure is known as the globular protein. This tertiary structure is held together by non-covalent bonds such as a hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces. And there are also tertiary structure and quaternary structure. And let us see tertiary structure. These are the special arrangement of the secondary structure proteins. The alpha helical or beta sheets are further folded to form a tertiary structure. These proteins are also known as a globular proteins. This tertiary structure is held together by non-covalent bonds such as a hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces. This is the best example of a hemoglobin structure. It is a tertiary structure just like this only. And quaternary structure, arrangements of the multiple folded protein subunits in a multi-subunit complex. Bonding is via non-covalent bonds such as a hydrogen bonding, salt bridges, the dimer containing two subunits, trimer containing three subunits. So hemoglobin is an example for the quaternary structure. And this is the primary amino acid. By using a primary amino acid chain, it will form the alpha helix. Left side and the secondary structure, these two structures, their atoms and their tertiary structures also. There's the heme unit. So these are the hemoglobin quaternary structure. And protein function. O2 does not easily diffuse in muscle, and O2 is a toxic to biological system. So living system have developed a way around this. So physiological roles of myoglobin. So myoglobin functions is it is a transport oxygen in rapidly respiring muscle. Monomer, it is a monomer, single unit, and store of oxygen in muscle, high affinity for oxygen. Diving animals have a large concentration of myoglobin to keep oxygen supplies to muscle. So overall it is a oxygen storage protein. And hemoglobin, the function of hemoglobin is it found in the red blood cells, like we called it RBCs, and it carries the oxygen from lungs to the tissue and removes of CO2 and
hydrogen ions from blood to lungs. So lower affinity for oxygen than myoglobin. So compared to myoglobin, its affinity, oxygen affinity is lower. So it is a tetramer, two sets of similar units, one is alpha and beta, whereas the myoglobin is a only single unit. Next slide. So this is the sum of the oxygen carriers, hemoglobin, myoglobin structures, and heme. It is having the four pyrrole rings linked together by CH, that is the methylidene bridges, four pyrene. The four pyrene with the side chain propionic acid in position A, H methyl groups in a positions B, C, E, G, and a vinyl group is a position DF, four pyrene ring, which is shown in the structure. When the two hydrogen on the center nitrogens in the four pyrenes are replaced by one iron atom, the resulting compound is heme. So globin, heme means this is the position of heme. And whereas what about globin? Globin is a large number of amino acid residue joined by peptide bonds. This is the structure of hemoglobin. There is a four pyrene ring, and sixth position, there is a sixth position, it will show oxygen molecules, fifth position individual rings. So this is the model of hemoglobin. By this model they got Nobel Prize in 1962. That scientist name was John Kennedy, and a British scientist. Myoglobin is the first protein to have been completely described in terms of its 3D geometry. This achievement won John Kennedy a shared the 1962 Nobel Prize of Chemistry. The structure of hemoglobin. So this is a very important. The structure of hemoglobin. There is a primary, a secondary, and tertiary structures are same as that of myoglobin. Quaternary structure having four units consist of the quaternary structures. It is made up of two identical pairs of units, that is alpha and beta, roughly arranged in the tetrahedron with a dimension of 50 angstroms into 55 angstroms into 69 angstroms. Two alpha chains, one alpha, two alpha, have 141 amino acid, almost 141 amino acid each, and two beta chains have 146 amino acids each. Altogether, there are a total number of 574 amino acid residue in the four chains. Chain difference only in amino acid sequence, and four subunits are held together by a hydrogen bonding, salt bridges, electrostatic interaction. These four subunits also held together by using of these bonds. What is that bonds? Hydrogen bonding, salt bridges, and electrostatic interaction. So this is another detailed structure of the hemoglobin and myoglobin differences. Primary structure, myoglobin having only 153 amino acid, hemoglobin having 141 and 141 alpha chain, 146 beta chain amino acid. And secondary structure, 8 alpha helix of myoglobin, whereas hemoglobin 8 alpha helix for each alpha chain and beta chain. Tertiary structure, folding of alpha helix, folding of alpha helixes. Quaternary structure, none, there is a monomer of myoglobin, there is no quaternary structure, whereas the hemoglobin tetramer of two identical alpha beta dimers. Functions, its myoglobin is oxygen storage and hemoglobin is the oxygen delivery.